the level of toleration that the citizens have for their elected officials has always been amazing to me. The, in my opinion, many times lack of integrity in these crazy situations like this demonstrate the reason why the taxpayer money in this state is completely awry. They can't agree on anything. They're constantly at each other's throats. There's no more integrity with regard to how they're supposed to act. Now, I don't mean that every politician is going to shoot an arrow at somebody's house, but many times they do that in a political sense. But with this case, as prosecutor, I would be all over it. It's intimidating a public official. This is the reason why good people don't want to get involved in politics. Of course, you have to prove that he's the person that shot the arrow. And
right.
Not now, somebody
can
else
I ask you, Bob, like I made a comment that I think we're sort of lulled into this false sense of reality when it comes to law enforcement. Like it's all like a CSI show that all of a sudden they've got the laser pointers and the DNA match and they'll find the guy in an hour. And I'm not knocking law enforcement, but I got to believe it's just a little more primitive than that.
Yeah, I mean, this is something we deal with at trial all the time. I'm explaining to a jury as prosecutors that this isn't like TV. It's not going to be wrapped up in half an hour, and you can't look at a piece of dirt and figure out who committed the crime.
Right.
But they definitely will take that arrow, and if it were me, it's all a question of what level law enforcement wants to go to. I consider this a very, very serious threat.
Yeah.
Because it's chilling to the political process. There could be things like touch DNA, potentially fingerprints, but they may not go to that level with a case like this because they usually reserve them for things like homicides or what have you. But I would definitely look into any kind of forensic analysis on this arrow because it obviously is a very, very disconcerting thing to be shooting something. It's so reckless conduct. It's frightening. Now, the whole family, with cases like this, Bill, you have to understand what it does to the family.
Yeah.
They don't know when they walk out every minute whether or not somebody's going to be shooting something at them. Obviously, people are so upset. Somebody's so upset that they did something like this. It's a really chilling effect on politicians.
What's the procedure for the cops? I mean, now, do they patrol his house extra? Do they sit in front? What do you do? And do they take it seriously? Like, do they look at it as some nut? Or, hey, this guy could have a legitimate threat out there.
No, they definitely will be giving extra level of security at his house. They're going to be canvassing the neighborhood to see whether or not anybody saw anything, saw a car. They're going to be pulling down tapes probably in the areas of wherever this was to see on the highways and so on and so forth,
yeah,
whether or not they can find maybe this person if he's a person of interest. They're going to be doing interviews of somebody if they think was involved in this. So they're going to be doing a number of different things, and I would imagine the prosecutor's office will probably be involved in that too because it's obviously an extremely serious thing, and it's against the public official.
Right. Okay. All right. Former prosecutor Bob Bianchi, thank you for calling in to New Jersey 101.5. Appreciate your perspective and your professional opinion. As always, we'll be talking again real soon. Have a great day,
okay,
Bob.
Thanks.